no need to be nervous, my man. We're just hanging out, chit-chatting.
Do you still get nervous before competitions?
Oh, very much so.
Really?
Yeah, definitely. Always, no matter what, whether it's the CrossFit Games or like a local throwdown, I think at this point for me, there's a little bit of like that expectation kind of that I have to do well. Mm. And so that makes me nervous that like, oh, if I don't live up to these other people's expectations or my own expectations, then I'm going to let people down, let myself down, whatever it may be. But yeah, definitely still get the nerves.
Yeah, it's interesting because even like you said, after your, when you were putting up, I think it was the day after the games, you put up a post. And the thing that stuck out to me was that you were like, oh, I hope I didn't let any of you down. And it's kind of like it's heartbreaking in a way because that I know, like, I guess fans can be fickle, but like, it's heartbreaking that you'd see or that you think that the possibility would be there for people to be like, oh, screw that guy. Like, he didn't live up to what I want him to be. Like, you know, it's kind of, I suppose it's easy to forget that, like you say, there, people get nervous and people still have that weight of expectation. It probably gets worse, I suppose, because even I was, I found it funny the other day, I was searching your name. The word that came up was like, you know, CrossFit Games veteran. And I was kind of like, it must be crazy.
That's interesting.
To be like 29 and considered a veteran of the sport, you know, like it's just, I know you've been around a while, but it kind of adds to that weight of expectation that you're talking about.
Yeah, I agree. And it's interesting because I think the nerves have shifted over the years, because at first you're nervous because you don't have the experience. Everything's so new and you don't know what to expect. And then as you do become the veteran, I think now you're more comfortable in the environment. Like you're not nervous about what's going to happen. You kind of more or less know how it's going to unfold in a way, but the nerves are, all right, I expect and hope for it to go this way. Is it going to meet that expectation?
Yeah. Yeah, no, it is interesting, I think. Because even, like, I used to get nervous, like, at the start of, you know, before I record every episode, I get a bit nervous.
Yeah.
But then I guess it's the same as, well, the same in a very different way as, like, competing, where, say, I interviewed Shane Orr, and I only found out maybe 15 minutes before I interviewed him that it was going to happen.
Nice.
In hindsight, it was a relief, because I think if I had had any extra amount of time, I would have like needed hospitalization. And I think it's similar for this one, where I thought, you know, I was kind of like, oh, I didn't tell anyone because I was like, oh, he like something like, oh, it might not happen or whatever. And then when there was like a gap in communication, I was like, nah, he's probably just forgotten about it. It's fine. I'll get in touch with him another time. And then when I was like, oh, is this still happening? You were like, yeah. Again, I was relieved that I only had like 2 days to think about it and not 2 weeks. Yeah. Like, because the anticipation is sometimes worse. And it affects the reality then.
Totally. And I can relate to that big time. Last year, the 2019 CrossFit Games, when we didn't know any of the events ahead of time and they were all released on the spot, I loved that. I was able to go to bed every night without my mind racing, thinking about what the event was going to be the next day. This year and in other years where we know the events ahead of time and you have to sit there and go over your strategy, and I would have dreams, vivid dreams about the event playing out. Like, I would much rather not know myself than to know. So I feel you there, but